The content of the following program is not intended to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, treatment, or cure. Always consult your physician or a health professional with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Go higher, baby. You're in the right place. You're listening to One Life Radio. This is Bernadette with Anthony Cernelia. I've got Diamond Gray here somewhere. She's not in studio. She's probably running around doing stuff for us. And of course, Lexi Brinkley, Aviana Barrientos, Eva Marie's here. So, and our special guests in studio today are Chelsea Barlow and Fitz Lauder. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing great.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I am too. I rocked all the way here today in my car listening to music. I don't know if they were able to roll that in, but we're gonna give our listeners a little treat today. I like to do that and just play some of my favorite songs instead of just talk or try to sell something or change your mind about something or just educate. I actually don't want to change somebody's mind. I don't think it's ever good to change somebody's mind. You just give them the information and let them make up their own mind, right?
Well, that's the best way to educate. I think it's a lot more empowering when they change their own mind.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You plant the seeds.
You plant the seeds. There you go. So we're going to be talking, speaking of seeds, you know, one of the things that we're going to be talking about today is the Bach flower essences. And no, they're not paying for this. I've just always used them and they've worked on me. But I've heard that they're, you know, that a placebo works just as well. So we're going to talk all about that. Right. And of course, Fitz, always great to have you in studio. We're going to talk about that with Chelsea Barlow to complete my thought and my statement. And Fitz Lauder and I are going to be talking about the effects of meat on the environment. And we're going to be talking about that. So are you passionate about it?
Oh, I'm super passionate about it.
I'm super passionate about the environment. And I think this, you know, anybody should be able to eat whatever they want as long as there's no cruelty attached to it. When it's cruel is where you lose me. So, but so much to talk about.
We don't even cover the part about how it's cruel to the environment. Too.
Yeah, to the environment. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, it's cruel, period. Yeah. So we do have to be sharper. We really need to be sharper because there's so much going on in the world right now and we need to protect our environment. We don't have another one.
Yeah,
it's not like we can move to another planet. So. Mm-hmm. I know they've been working on it for a long time, but I don't think it's happening anytime soon. And I kind of like Earth. I don't want to move.
It's the only home we got.
I know, right? Well, so many little things I want to get out here today, just stuff that I've read and maybe I've talked about before. But one of the things that I really am passionate about is children. And heavy screen time, okay, appears to impact children's brains. There's a study. I'm sure you could comment on this. Chelsea, can you comment on this? Do you have an opinion?
I know there's a bunch of studies out there.
Yeah, there really is. But this is from the National Institute of Health. Study is showing that those 9 and 10 year old kids spending more than 7 hours a day. I can't even imagine a child, first of all, spending 7 hours a day on a digital device or a phone or a laptop or anything. That's far too many hours. They need to be out climbing trees in nature
or learning,
reading
in school.
Exactly. Or reading in school. I mean, 7 hours, that's crazy. But it says spending 7 hours a day using such devices shows signs of premature thinning of the cortex, the brain's outermost layer that processes sensory information. And we don't know if it's being caused by the screen time. We don't know yet if it's a bad thing. How could that be a good thing? Opinions, anyone?
Well, it wouldn't be a good thing. You need all the body parts that we were designed to have. We
Absolutely.
Need to have those body parts intact and at full strength.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. But I think that I didn't even check the date on this. Well, yes, here it's from 12/10/2018. So it's pretty current. But it also said that the NIH data reported on CBS also showed that kids who spent more than 2 hours a day on screens scored worse on language and reasoning tests. Well, that makes perfect sense. And this study involves scanning the brains of 4,500 children, eventually aims to show that whether the screen time is addictive, but researchers need several years to understand such long-term outcomes. So, and Lexi, you've got a new baby and you've got a new niece.
I do.
A new niece, Aviana.
Everyone's switching books for iPads. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's up with that?
I don't know.
Do you read to Jackson, sorry.
I haven't started reading yet.
Like, oh, you haven't?
I have all the books sitting out, and at night I told myself I'm going to start doing bath time and book time because I want to read to him. But I don't know. I haven't yet. But yeah. I sing to him all the time, and he just loves it. He eats it up.
Well, speaking,
but I can't. I'm going to say this. He's very attracted to the TV. So,
well, there's a first. And so, okay. So, do you guys watch a lot of TV?
I live with a man who watches sports all day long.
Sports is okay.
But I turn on these like cartoons that are nursery rhymes for him, and he's just mesmerized by the colors and the sounds. And
they say that young children shouldn't be watching any television. I'm pretty sure about that. Chelsea, do you happen to know? I'm going to you because I know you're a nature mama.
What do you do?
I teach homeschool, and we are on devices for homeschool. So, you know, when you're reading that, you're preaching to someone who knows better. But like all of our school is done through online curriculum. You know, we go in, log in.
That's different than television, though, with the commercials and everything moving so quickly. And
now, my firstborn, who's 21 now, you know, he was raised on PBS, Teletubbies, and all
that. My kids,
that's
the only thing I would let him watch is PBS, and then the television was
off.
Now
I seriously regret that decision. But
you regret what? Even PBS?
Yeah, I don't like the curriculum that they put on there. But but as far as screen time, yeah, it's going to be detrimental. Hearing our voice is, and they learn through their mother tongue. So hearing our voice, the fact that you're singing to your son melts my heart because
it's really bad, but it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
I sing to my dogs.
That's awesome.
My kids are so big now that when I sing to them, they say, "Shut up, Mom." Or they'll go, "Wow, Mom.
That's really good."
So there's a whole part of homeschool education that's very much where the mother or the father reads to the children, even the books they're going through. It's a reading method.
It's something very beneficial
about the frequency and the connection with the parents reading.
Well, speaking. It's been happening since the beginning. I mean, that's one of the great things, you know, to me anyway, raising children was being able to read them books. Some of my most treasured memories are reading to them. We would get like a stack, and you have to do it age appropriate, but any kind of reading is good to them. You can read the newspaper and they hear it and it doesn't matter. But
my grandmother used to mail me cassette tapes of her reading Mr. Rogers.
Oh, how cute.
And I listen to him over and over and over again.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. Well, I love PBS, but I do. And if I had children right now, I would have them watching PBS as well. But that's probably about the only television. But no judging, I swear, because, you know,
It's just nursery rhymes. And it's very, like, I just think it's good for him to, like, hear. It's the numbers, it's the shapes, it's wheels on the bus. I mean, it's not anything.
The wheels on the bus go
There's also
round
the
and
value
I
of the
I've heard that so many times.
I can remember singing that.
There's also the value of the rhythmic part of nursery rhymes that definitely helps with brain structure along with true classical music. There's a brain structure development.
I mean, he's already to the age where he's like cooing and singing along with it. And so I'm like, it's got to be beneficial. It's not him just staring blankly at a screen where he doesn't know what's happening.
I had something here earlier about classical music. Let me see. Oh, here it is. It says take a 25-minute music break. It says less than a half an hour of listening to Mozart can notably lower blood pressure and heart rate, according to a study at Ruhr University, Bochum in Germany. The soothing, slow tempos tunes like tamp down levels of cortisol, a stress hormone that contributes to high blood pressure. Not a classical fan? Then take heart. Our researchers note that as long as the music you're listening to is lyric free, well, I don't know if I agree with that because it feels good to sing too. Because I was singing the Midnight Special all the way here today by CCR and like grooving in my car. But it's really good for you. So I think you should listen to music every single day. I know I do. And I feel bad for people like that are in nursing homes or rehabilitative homes I've been in recently. There's no music anywhere. There should be music going through the system, in my opinion, to keep those people from, you know, becoming so lethargic,
if
you will.
At the one my grandma's at, they have a woman who comes in like twice a week and she sings.
I think it's so important.
Like the cafeteria area.
I would have rock and roll night at my nursing home.
You know, music has a place in everything, really.
I mean, I can't even imagine my life without music.
Jogging,
just kill me now. Oh, yeah.
I like to dance when I cook, too.
Oh, me, too.
Place.
Yeah. Well, and you're
great,
a DJ. So you, yeah, we got to get you, we got to get you to start picking some of the music for some of our shows. That would be cool.
Or playing some of your music.
Yeah,
yeah,
there you go.
Let's do it.
We should.
Yeah. Well, you know, I want to get this out here, too, because I feel that this is something that's so important. It's about styrofoam, okay? And I know we're completely switching gears here, but styrofoam really is bad for your health. The chemicals leach into your food. It's just really, really bad for you. It's bad for the environment. You were speaking about the environment. It takes thousands and thousands and thousands of years for it to break down in our environment. And there have been studies linked to say that it causes cancer. So why are we still manufacturing it? Do you know?
It's cheap.
Yeah. Good answer. See?
People still demand it because it keeps their ice cold.
Yeah.
Especially in Texas.
Really? Because yes. It keeps their ice cold?
Keeps their ice from melting instantly in Texas.
Mm-hmm.
So my husband's, he works outside all year long. Uh-huh. And in the winter, so he's switched over to like Grizzly or Yeti cups. So he doesn't need the styrofoam. But if you're a consumer and you're going to fast food and you need that cup of ice to last you several hours, you're going to want a styrofoam rather than just a paper cup.
Unless you care more about the earth. You drink your water a little warm. Mm-hmm. It's probably better for you anyway. In Europe, they don't have styrofoam over there.
Awesome.
It's bad for the environment and it's bad for you. So don't do it.
All true.
Get yourself an insulated cup.
That's right. But we've got a great show coming up. We're going to be talking about Bach flower essences with Chelsea Barlow and a lot of other things. And Fitz Lauder, the effects of meat on the environment. Stay tuned, everyone. You're listening to One Life Radio. Better food means better living. At True Foods Kitchen, healthy isn't just an idea. Healthy is science, and they take it seriously. Every delicious dish and drink at True Food Kitchen is crafted to be better for your taste buds and your body. True Foods Kitchen, a place to bring people together, feel better, and celebrate a passion for better living. Check them out at truefoodkitchen.com.
Give your body some soul with Sun Warrior's new Soul Good Protein Bars. Sun Warrior is committed to making the best plant-based proteins and superfood supplements from the finest organic ingredients across the globe. Soul Good Bars have an amazing profile. They have 17 to 19 grams of clean organic protein, very low sugar, and 16 to 17 grams of fiber. They're available in delicious flavors like blueberry blast, coconut cashew, cinnamon roll, and salted caramel. Check them out online at sunwarrior.com. That's sunwarrior.com. And give your adventure some soul.
Call us crazy. We don't mind. Crazy Water's all-natural mineral water has been making people feel good inside and out since 1881. As the only mineral water bottled in Texas, their water boasts loads of benefits that other bottled waters can only envy. Pretty crazy, huh? Find it at your local Whole Foods, HEB, Central Market, or have it shipped right to your door. Visit them at drinkcrazywater.com. That's drinkcrazywater.com.
Wanting to try CBD but not sure what to trust? Check out H-Hemp H, like healthy, happy, honest. H-Hemp's CBD system makes it simple with one CBD tincture available in three great tasting flavors. A super powerful breath spray that GQ magazine named a top CBD product. And a topical CBD balm that is simply the bomb. So relax and feel better naturally with the H-Hemp CBD system, available at hhemp.com.
You know, my mom always said, do something well or not at all. Frosted Art Bakery has been around a long time, almost 70 years, doing it well. I was so impressed with the cake that I asked them to make for our special guest, Jen Sincero, the author of the book, You Are a Badass. They actually made a cake that looked exactly like the book. It was incredible. But I guess I shouldn't have been surprised, because Frosted Art Bakery has a reputation for being one of the best bakeries in the Metroplex, serving Dallas, Plano, Frisco, Addison, The Colony, and Southlake. Life is short and you only get one. Enjoy a slice of Frosted Art today. Find them at frostedart.com. That's frostedart.com. Wow. Welcome back to One Life Radio, everyone. This is Bernadette with Anthony Cernelia. I've got Diamond Gray in studio with me, Lexi Brinkley, Aviana Barrientos, and I have Chelsea Barlow in studio with me and Fitz Lauder. And we're talking about a lot of different things here today. Just so you